Welcome back, trainers, and in this video we're going to be taking a look at the new event that is going to be kind of tying into the main series game and giving us a few nice things here. So first off, let's go ahead and take a look at the new outfit, Go's outfit, as a matter of fact. And I had no prior knowledge of this, but somebody else told me that they named Go that because of the popularity of Pokemon Go, and I kind of hinted towards that. So hey, awesome. So the clothes, I'm not gonna lie, they look pretty good. I'm gonna rock the top and the pants, and I'm gonna just wear those boots, and it makes my boots. Look at my foot, the one that's turned. It looks like my ankle's broken. And look at the gloves. We're gonna talk about that. We're gonna go over everything you need to know, but first, I want you guys to see the revenue that Niantic has made. $1 billion in 2020. $1 billion. Do you know what that is? $1 billion? Do you know what you can do with $1 billion? A lot. And we are seeing bugs after bugs after bugs. And you want to see the response to somebody who was locked out because somebody dodged them in Go Battle League and they can't get back in and they get the errors? Sorry for the trouble, trainer. The errors should be fixed upon restarting the app. If that does not work, then you can go ahead and reinstall it. Reinstall? That's your solution? You gotta be joking me. Come on. So with that said, let's go ahead and take a look at what we have for this event going down November 6th until November 12th, local time. And just to celebrate the 1 billion, I'm going to put the image of this broken hat and hoodie with the 1 billion next to it there. Just, you know, so we can just, you know, reflect on all this. All right, so we know that Lugia is going to be here with Aeroblast and potentially to be shiny, which is going to be awesome. And then they go on to say we're going to have time research that's going to be revolving around the main series Pokemon Journeys. I don't know, maybe their viewership was down and they needed to like promote it or something. And then we're gonna have a few other things, including saying you might encounter a shiny Cubone. Okay, let's get into it. So the spawns in the wild are going to be Bulbasaur, potentially shiny, Sparrow, no shiny, World Hat Pikachu, potentially shiny, Paris, Meowth, potentially shiny, Execute, shiny, Cubone, shiny, Scyther, shiny, Dratini, shiny, Cyntaquil, shiny, Rumple, shiny, and Piplup shiny. So you have those Pokemon in the wild to potentially shiny check if that's what you like to do. Taking a look at the raids that we do have for this current event, you have Ivysaur, Pinsir, Snorlax, Lugia shiny, and then Golurk. That's pretty interesting, seeing that its first stage is going to be somewhat rare and some people simply don't have candies or very many of the first stage to evolve any. So that's going to be pretty awesome. And then they highlight the shiny here. This is going to be done by Leaked Duck, these images here. So shout out to them, and I will have a link in the description. And then they put that image there because they highlighted it for some reason. Out of the 7 kilometer eggs, we do have Cubone shiny, Pichu shiny, Ryolu. There you go. There's the jackpot shiny. And then you have Mantyke, which is going to be the dud thing that you don't want to see. I mean, Cubone too. Pichu technically too. All right. And then you're going to have Photobomb with Scyther. I don't know what's up with this. You got the potential shiny there, but they said Go was going to Photobomb. So is it between both of them? I'm a little confused on that. All right. Now going over the special research here, let's go ahead and go over this fairly quick. For the first one, we're going to have catch 5 Pokemon, transfer a Pokemon, make 3 nice throws. For 2 of 11, we have battle another trainer, battle in a raid, and win a raid. 3 of 11, defeat 3 Team Go Rocket Grunts, catch 2 Pokemon with Weather Boost, and then catch 3 Grass-type Pokemon, which are going to yield you some nice Mega Energy. And then for 4 of 11, you have give your buddy 3 treats, earn a heart with your buddy. It's pretty simple there. Just take a snapshot or rub it on the belly or something like that, and then earn a candy walking with your buddy. And, you know, that one may take you just a little bit, depending on your situation. So there you have the first sets, 4 through 11. Let's go ahead and move on. We have 5 of 11, catch 3 Bug-type Pokemon, use 3 berries to help catch a Pokemon, and then make an excellent throw for potential shiny Venonat. For 6 of 11, we have battle in a gym 2 times, win a gym battle, so that's going to be knocked out right when you do the first one as well, and then battle another trainer. That's going to be for 6 of 11. For 7 of 11, you have hatch an egg, spin a Pokestop or a gym 3 times, and then spin a Pokestop or a gym 3 times. 2 of those? Okay, that's weird. Then for 8 of 11, make 3 nice throws in a row, catch a Flying-type Pokemon, purify a Shadow Pokemon, and that is going to get you the elusive Sparrow. Should I say Pharaoh? Okay, so there you have it for those. Looking pretty good, you know, it is some new stuff. And then for 9 of 11, you have evolve a Pokemon 3 times, power up a Pokemon 3 times, transfer 5 Pokemon, and then for 10 of 11, catch 5 Pokemon, make 3 great throws, battle in a raid, and then that's that. You're going to get yourself a Gengar, and then the last one, you're just going to simply claim the XP. So there you go, the Pokemon Journeys Special Research. Let's get it. I have to admit, the clothes are pretty cool. And bonus events are bonus events. All right, folks, so there you have it. If you did enjoy that portion, go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. And now I want to talk about something that I am very sorry about, folks. I really am. Yesterday, I put out a video saying, you know, it was some information from Ghost Stadium. And I got to talk about that here in just a moment as well, because it's not on them. But basically, they talked to Niantic and clarified. They said several times on the information that I did put out regarding you can do your battles before Go Battle League Night, which apparently is not true, and you're going to be able to do an additional 100. But in fact, if you do your sets before Go Battle Night for your area, 6 p.m. local time, your area, those battles that you did before the Go Battle Night are going to contribute to your Go Battle Night battles, so you're going to be stuck only being able to do 75. And I say only able to do 75. That's still a lot. So if you did do that, I want to sincerely apologize for that. And let's go back to Ghost Stadium really quick. And a little context for the battles that you're seeing. This is going to be Premier Master 5-0. Let's go. So Ghost Stadium, fantastic. They're good people. Good stuff. Good information. It's not their fault. This has happened many times before where Niantic support has given people wrong information. Those people take that information, put it on Reddit. The information starts spreading and it's wrong. And that customer support agent or whoever the heck is doing this has been spreading false information. I wouldn't say intentionally, just probably incompetently. Now, let's go back and talk about the $1 billion. Come on. Oh, come on, man. What's going on over here? They literally telling us to when we're getting the error 6 for the Go Battle League, when somebody dodges us, Niantic is telling us support to, okay, restart the app. Reasonable. That does not fix it. They say to reinstall it too. We saw it in the beginning of the video. They literally told us to uninstall and reinstall it. Are you kidding me? $1 billion over there, Dr. Evil, and you can't even run a correct app? I mean, what is going on here, folks? We have poured so much money into this. What are they doing? Are they all just building multiple, like, retirement homes or what? I don't know. It seems a little weird. And it's not just Niantic, it's the Pokemon companies. This is like deeper than the staff, right? So I'm not just trying to take shots at the staff, but I am the voice of this nonsense. Nobody else wants to speak out towards it. I don't know if they're afraid or they just want to be neutral, but I'm not trying to be aggressive. I'm not. But I mean, what's going to give? Well, I mean, what are we going to hear? Like in 2021, Niantic's revenue was $3 billion. And the game is still going to be broken. Is that acceptable? Okay, all right. So there's a rant. We're getting into a little bit of a rant here. And no, I'm not upset about the elections. Okay, that's not my built-up tension. I'm nor left or right. But I'm not even going to go down that road. That's crazy. I know a lot of people are upset about what's going on. But anyway, no, that's not my tension. I'm just annoyed by the fact that they actually told somebody to uninstall and reinstall their app to make it work. Oh my gosh. All right. So yeah, I just wanted to tell you guys that. And it's also kind of like, who are the people that are giving out this information to other people when they ask it? I mean, they should have legit everything that they need to know regarding specific information for events coming up that people are going to be going to these customer support agents and asking them for help or asking them what's going to happen. Or maybe they shouldn't give out any information at all. I mean, I'd rather take no information that over false information and spreading it and making you guys do stuff that you shouldn't have. And then I make myself look like a fool. Go Stadium makes themselves look like a fool. And anybody else who shared that information is looking pretty silly. And also people are, you know, they could have benefited from this. And what's the big deal? Ooh, it's 25 battles. All right, yeah, I know. It's not the end of the world. The world is going through some massive problems right now. That's not the issue. Correct. This is a Pokemon Go channel, though, and I'm trying to express the issues that we're currently going through, right? I know there's people hungry. I know there's things that are happening around the world, and I'm over here with first world problems. Oh, Go Battle League, right? So, yeah, there's that. So just enjoy the battles as I rant here. I know a lot of people like to hear these rants, so it's ranted up, folks. All right, so, yeah, there you go. Let's just Cooler Jets, everybody relax. It's more like Poke, you just relax. But basically, when you're going to be doing your Go Battle League battles, here's the thing. You're going to be able to yield a lot more Stardust. We're talking a lot. My friend was telling me upwards towards... I don't even want to even tell you anything that unless I see it myself. I don't like to hear from here this and hear that. You know, he say, she say stuff. Because then that ends up being wrong. But apparently you're going to be able to get a ton of Stardust from this knight, though. I'm not going to give a number, but a lot. So if you did do your sets, you're just going to be missing out on that. And apparently I got this information from my followers on Twitter, multiple people, and they said that all leagues are going to be open. You're not going to be stuck just doing Flying Cup, okay? So don't worry about that. I know it is. I'm excited for Flying Cup, and it is interesting. Battles are going to go quick. But not everybody wants to do that, right? That's a lot of battles to just go with Flying Cup over and over and over and over and over again. You can switch it up, have a little diversity, do what you want to do, and have some fun. So there's that information for you guys. And there. Rant over. Okay? So let's go ahead and see what we have going on for these battles, even though they're almost over here. So we're going to be finishing off with the Snorlax. We built up enough energy to hit that superpower, taking out that Magnezone. Let's go. Do you believe... I'm not too sure which battle this is. Might be like the fifth one or fourth. So we have a great lead. This is fantastic. So yeah, we're going with their team that we made here, the Haxorus, Snorlax, and Metagross that has become quite popular. And I'm loving it. Haxorus is freaking amazing. It's really weak to Togekiss for sure, but man oh man, it pulls off those charge moves quick. So at this point, we're just farming down. Now we have a bunch of energy. They're going in with Togekiss, and we're going to immediately swap into our Snorlax here. Yeah, we're looking fine. We are down a shield. This is obviously a 5-0, so let's see what happens. This is a Brave Soul. They did not shield that, and they have two shields left, and they do not shield this. They were like, nah, man, I'm not stupid. I know what you're going for. So awesome calls. Good calls. So they're going for that wild charge, bringing their defense down, and they're going to be going for a mirror shot to take us out. We still have one shield. They still have two. I go in here with Metagross and farm it down. And they have that Togekiss back there. So, yeah, it's GG's at this point. They back out. We're able to take that. Fantastic, folks. And that's it. That's all she wrote. We're looking good. So, at least I got a 5-0. See, I fell victim to it as well. I mean, I did some of my sets. Not all of them, but I did some of them. So, there we go, folks. Hope you have a good time in your Flying Cup. And if you already did it, hope you had a good time. Thank you for watching, and I'll be catching you all next time. Take care.